Assalamu alaikum students, welcome back to your online class of maths. Children, in today's class we are continuing the fifth chapter, that is numbers beyond 100. And in previous class we have learned before, after and between. Children, before numbers are also called predecessor and after numbers are also called successor. So in exercise 5.4 we have completed till second question. So we have to start third one, that is write true for true, write T for true and F for false. The predecessor of 132 is 123. 132, predecessor is nothing but before number. So what is the predecessor of 132? 131, but it is given here 123, so it is false. The successor of 568 is 569. Successor is nothing but after numbers, so successor of 568 is 569, so it is true, so write true here. The predecessor of 330, the predecessor of 330 is 329, so it is also a true statement, so write T here. The successor of 449, successor is nothing but after number, so 449, what comes after 449? 450. So it is also true. Next, fourth question. Write the odd numbers between 400 and 420. Children, odd numbers ends with 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So 401, 403, 405, 407. 409, 411, 413, 415, 417, 419. These are the odd numbers between 400 to 420. Write the even numbers between 671 to 691. So 672, even numbers end with 2, 4, 6, 8, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So 672, 674, 676, 678, 680, 682. Like that only, children, you have to write till 690. Okay, next, find the predecessor and successor of the following numbers. So here it is given, between numbers has given here, so we have to write predecessor and successor, that is before and after numbers. What comes before 699? 698. What comes after 699? 700. What comes before 401? 400. What comes after 401? 402. And 364 is predecessor of 365. And 366 is the successor of 365. And 588 is the predecessor of 589. And 590 is successor of 589. So children, in the same way you have to write before and after numbers for these three digit numbers. The next chapter, the next topic here is numbers on the abacus. Already you know that what is abacus. So children, in three digit numbers, this right hand side will represent ones and this left hand side represent hundreds and this middle will represent tens. So children, if the number is given, so you have to write the you have to draw the beads on it. We have number 123. So 3 on 1s, so draw 3 beads. And 2 on 10s, draw 2 beads on 10s place. And 1 on 100s, so draw 1 bead on 100. In the same way, we have the number 354. So 4 is on 1s, 5 is on 10s, 3 is on 100s. So draw 4 beads on 1s wire, 5 beads on 10s wire, 3 beads on 100s place. Next, exercise 5.5. Children, here beads are given. You have to count and you have to write the number. On 100s place, we have only 1. And on 10s, we have 3. And on 1s, we have 6. So the number here is 136. 136. Next here, on 100s place, we have 7. But on 10s place, we don't have any number. So that is 0. Here no beads are there, that means 0. Here, and 4 on 1s place. So the number here is 704. Next here, on 100s we have 6, on 10s we have 4, and on 1s we have 0. So the number here is 640. Next, the second question, children. In this, we have to count beads and we have to write the number. But here, the number has given. You have to draw the number of beads on the correct wire. So 4 is on 100, so draw 4 beads on 100s. 2 is on 10s, so draw 2 beads on 10s wire. And 5 is on 1s, so 5 beads on 1s. So children, this is the numbers on abacus. Thank you, children. Be ready for the next class. Love is...